This PCB is showing the L3 error, which I've installed here, and you can see the blinking indicators here as well. Moreover, the indoor unit is displaying the L3 error directly because the outdoor unit isn't working at all. The compressor and fan have completely stopped. At the moment, the indoor unit continues to operate, but the outdoor unit isn't working at all. To understand the outdoor faults, it's important to know about the lights that are blinking here. There are three lights here. One is completely off. The green light is the operating light, and there's a red light. The yellow light is currently off. Here, you can see that D3 is labeled on the yellow light, but whenever the L3 error appears, the red light labeled D1 blinks. Currently, it's giving two types of blinks, one sequence of 14 blinks and another of 8 blinks. The 8 blinks indicate that the outdoor unit temperature is normal, with no issues. However, the 14 blinks indicate an L3 error, specifically pointing to a fan motor problem in the outdoor unit, so you should resolve that issue. As I mentioned, the L3 error indicates a fan problem, specifically with the motor, which is a UVW type motor. I've made a video about this type of motor before, as it's controlled by the outdoor PCB through its UVW connections. Now, let's go ahead and check the outdoor PCB and inspect all the UVW points and related components to troubleshoot and fix this issue. Now, regarding this PCB, we need to check the IPM, intelligent power module, for the UVW connections. Let's locate the IPM first. You can see this IC here, which is the IPM. I'll guide you on which points to check for voltages. First, we'll check the voltages at the three UVW terminals. Additionally, there are four more points where voltage checks are necessary. Starting with ZD1, measure the voltage at its cathode side. Similarly, check the voltage at the cathode of ZD3, which serves as an output. Then, check the cathode side of ZD2 as well. Lastly, look at diode D206 and check its cathode side for the required voltage levels. As you can see, I've turned on the PCB and it's currently working properly. Now, we need to check the voltages at various points using a multimeter set to DC voltage. Starting with D206 on its cathode side, we should find 15 volts, which we have here. Next, ZD2 should also show 15 volts on its cathode side. Then, ZD1 on its cathode side should show 15 volts as well, and the same goes for ZD3. If we have 15 volts at all these points, we're in good shape. Finally, the UVW points should also have 15 volts, which we're seeing here, indicating that all functions are operating correctly so far. Now, we'll need to investigate further to pinpoint where the actual problem lies. We've checked the voltages, and everything appears to be fine. However, despite this, the fan motor is still not functioning. Now, we need to investigate further. First, since the fan motor isn't working, we need to focus on the operational amplifier and check all the resistances around it. There are three resistors here, each with a resistance of 0.5 ohms. Check these to ensure that they are functioning properly. If any of these are faulty, the unit won't operate correctly. Next, there are six resistors that are 2.7 ohms each. Check these as well. After that, there are resistors with a resistance of 10 kilo ohms. Make sure to check these too. Now that we've checked all the resistances and they seem fine, the next step is to replace the operational amplifier, as it could also be faulty. By changing it, we might resolve the issue and the fan should start operating again. We checked one of the resistors and replaced it with a 15 milliohm resistor. Additionally, we've removed the operational amplifier to check all the surrounding resistors, as high voltages might have caused damage to it. There could be other resistors that are burnt out as well, so we're replacing both the operational amplifier and the damaged resistor. We're hopeful that this will fix the PCB and get everything functioning properly again. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.